Good morning all of you. I am Shashikala Pawar. Today I am going to teach you one English poem. Okay? So before we start with the poem, I would like to ask you a few questions. See, here you can see the images of two ice creams. Okay? One is Amul brand and other is Baskin Robbins. Okay, if I say you, or if I ask you, among these two, any one ice cream you can have, or any one ice cream you can choose. So, which one would you like to choose, Rohini? Can you tell me?
Amul.
Why did you choose Amul?
Because I like its taste.
You like its taste. That means already you had Amul, you tasted it, and you liked its taste. Why not Baskin Robbins?
Because I have not tried it before.
You have not tried it before. Okay, and you don't want to try now also. Okay, that means you don't want to take any risk by tasting the other one. Already the one which you have tasted, you like its taste, so you want to go for that only. Okay, fine. Now we will see, suppose you went for shopping with your father, okay, and you took two shirts for you, okay. But your father asked you to purchase only one because he cannot afford two at a time. So if you have purchased these two colors because you liked it, you took these two colors because you liked them, but now you want to choose any one among these two. So what are you going to, which one you are going to choose?
Red one,
pink one. It is pink one. Okay, so you would like to choose pink one. Why pink?
Because I think the color suits me more than pink.
Okay, you feel that pink color suits you more than the yellow color. Okay, already you liked both the colors, but when there is only one option in front of you, that means only one you have to choose among these two, then you are going with pink color. So what did you think before choosing this?
Before choosing this, I wanted to buy both the t-shirts. Because I like both the colors.
Yes.
Red and yellow.
Yes. Okay. Yes, because your father gave you only one choice, so you choose pink one. And what did you? That means before choosing the pink one, you saw which one will suit more for you. Okay, and you took the one which suits more according to you. So in the same way, there are many options in our life. Okay, on every path of our life, we are having many options, and we choose the right one according to us. Okay, we choose the right one which we feel more appealing, which we feel this is the best one, that only we decide or we choose. Okay, same is with our career also. Okay, in our career, see, till 10th standard we are not that serious about our career. But after 10th, when we are moving for higher studies, at that time you have to go with any one subject. Okay, you have to make your career in any one subject. So at that time you are very confused. Yes, because your parents will say you go for science, but you want to go for commerce. Your relatives are saying go for IIT. Okay, so in this way there are many options in front of us, and what do we do at that time? We start, first we get confused, right? We get confused to which subject I should choose. Then you think over it. Okay, you think about your goals, you think about what you want to become in your life in future. Yes or no? And according to that, you choose the right one which you are with which you are more comfortable, or with which you can fulfill your goals. Okay, so you final decision is only yours. Okay, final decision you take and you decide what you want to do in your future. Okay, same is in this poem. Okay, today the poem which I am going to teach you is about confusion in the life, choices and decisions what we take in our life. So the name of our poem is The Road Not Taken. Okay, The Road Not Taken, written by Robert Frost. Okay, so now this poem, okay, this poem is completely about the confusion before making choice, and the choices that shape us and take us to our goals. Okay, it is a very interesting poem actually, and this poem is the theme of this poem. Theme of this poem completely highlights on confusion before making choices. Choices that decisions that you are going to take in your life, and the decisions which will reflect on your future, are the decisions which will make the difference in your life. Okay, the difference can be good or the difference can be bad, we can't say. Okay, it is not like that, that if we take any decisions they are always right. Okay, sometimes we also regret with our decisions, right? We feel, okay, this was my wrong decision. Okay, the decision which I took, this was wrong, and we regret with it. And sometimes we are very happy because whatever decision we take, okay, we succeed in that, so we are very happy at that time. So this poem is also about choices, confusion and decision. Okay, so before I start with the poem, I would like to give you some information about poet Robert Frost. Okay, Robert Frost is an American poet. Okay, he writes simply but insightfully. Okay, I'll show you the image of Robert Frost. Okay, so you can, you see here, see Robert Frost, he is an American poet who writes very simply and insightfully. Simply means he is using very simple words in his poem. Okay, but insightfully means that simple words are giving you very deep meaning. Okay, with deep meaning, and he is writing about ordinary experiences of everyday life. Okay, common and ordinary experiences, about that only he is writing. Okay, Robert Frost wrote this poem. Robert Frost wrote this poem in the year 1915. Okay, he wrote this poem in 1915. Actually, he wrote this poem for his friend Edward Thomas. Okay, for whom he wrote? Edward Thomas. Edward Thomas was his close friend, and Thomas would be always confused about his decisions which he used to take in the life. No, he would be always confused about it. So, thinking of Thomas, he wrote this poem. This poem was written in 1950, but afterwards it got published in the year 1916. It was published in Mountain Interval Collections. Okay, Mountain Interval Collections. Okay, it was published in Mountain Interval Collections as a opening poem. Okay, it was the first poem, and when this poem was written, this poem was given name as Two Roads. Okay, first this poem was named as Two Roads, but afterwards it got published with the name The Road Not Taken. Okay, and Robert Frost, he himself told that this is one of the most misunderstood or tricky poem. Okay, because whoever reads this poem will have, the reader of this poem will have their own interpretations, our own perceptions about this poem. Okay, so he told that this is a very tricky poem. Okay, and the poem, the title of the poem itself, okay, is very interesting, and it highlights the theme of the poem. Okay, so now we'll move towards the explanation of the poem. There are four stanzas in this poem. One by one I'm going to explain you. Okay, there are four stanzas in this poem. One stanza I will explain you. See, two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, and be one traveler long I stood, and looked down as far as I could, and where it bent in the undergrowth. See, two roads, there are two roads. Okay, you can imagine here they are two roads. Okay, which are diverged. Here I'll erase this. Which are diverged. Diverged means separated and took two different directions. Okay, diverged. means separated and took different directions. Okay, see, two roads, they are diverged, two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Yellow wood means yellow here is actually autumn season. Okay, yellow means autumn season. Why here yellow word is used instead of autumn season? Because in autumn season you can see leaves turn to yellow color and they start falling. So here poet has used yellow wood. Yellow wood means forest. Okay, wood means forest, yellow means autumn. Two roads diverged, okay, in a yellow wood. And sorry, I could not travel both. He is saying sorry. Why poet is sorry here? Because he is only the one traveler here. Okay, poet is alone. Okay, so as he is the only one traveler here, he can't travel both the roads at a time. Can he travel both the roads at a time? No. So he is unable to travel both the roads at a time. So he is saying sorry. And be one traveler, long I stood. As he is a one traveler, he stood long. That means he stood for a long time on the same place. Why he stood there? Thinking of going to which road. Okay. To which road I should go. He is thinking about it. And looked down as far as I could. He is looking towards both the roads. Okay. He is looking towards both the roads. As far as he could look, he is looking. Till here he can see both the roads. Till his vision is able, he is able to see the road. He is trying to see that far. Okay. To where it bent in the undergrowth. Undergrowth means? Undergrowth. Dense growth of plants and bushes. Okay, see, undergrowth means dense growth of plants and bushes. To where it bent in the undergrowth, where, till where the road is bending in the plants and bushes, till there he is trying to see both the roads. Okay, understood this paragraph? Now we'll go to the next stanza. Then took the other just as fair, having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. Okay, see, then took the other, poet is saying, then I took the other one. Okay, just as fair means according to him, he is feeling that is better one. Why he is saying the other? See, he gave names to both two roads. This is one and this is two. He took the other. He took the other. Okay. He felt this is better one. And having perhaps the better claim. Better claim means here which is more appealing. Okay. Better claim can is more appealing. Better claim, more appealing. Okay, that means he is saying, and having perhaps better claim, that means he is feeling that is more appealing to me, and I felt this is better compared to the first one. Because it was, why he took the second one? Because it was grassy and wanted wear. It was grassy. That means he is saying this road is more grassy. Wanted wear. Wanted wear here means had not been used. Wanted wear. Had not been used. That means this road is not much used because it is grassy. He is saying that this road is more grassy, so it is not more used. Okay. Though as for the passing there had warned them really about the same. But when he started passing on this road, when he started walking on this road, he felt that both are equally used. Warn means equally used. Okay, so when he started passing on this road, he felt that both the roads are equally used. Okay, and both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, at knowing how way leads on the way. I doubted if I should ever come back. See, he is saying that, and both that morning equally day. That means that morning both the roads were equally used, or we can say not used also. Why we can say not used? Because in the next line he is saying, in leaves no step had trodden black. Okay, trodden black means crushed. Trodden means crushed. Okay, trodden means crushed. Okay, he is saying that that morning, okay, no leaves had trodden black. That means the leaves were not crushed. After crushing leaves, what happened? They turn black. When we are walking on some leaves, or when we are walking on some grassy area, what happens? That area, that area gets, or that leaves get crushed and they turn black. Okay, when we walk on any grassy road, when it is used more, what happens? It turn black in color. So he is saying that this leaves are not trodden black. That means they are still fresh. So he is saying that both the roads are not that used. Okay, they are less used. Oh, I kept the first for another day, at knowing how way leads on to way. I doubted if I should ever come back. See, oh, I kept the first for another day. He is saying that the first road he kept for another day. Another day here means somewhere, sometime afterwards, whenever he will pass from here, he will take this road. Okay, next time whenever he will come here, he will take this road. Okay, but he is again doubtful at knowing how way leads on the way. He is having doubt. Now he took this path, this road, okay, where this road is going to take him, where this road is going to lead him. He don't know. Okay, he is saying, I don't know. That means knowing that where this road is going to take him, I doubted if I should ever come back. He is having doubt whether he will anytime come back or not on this path again. Okay, if he will come back sometime, then he will take the other one. But still again he is in confusion that whether he will come back or not on this path, he don't know, he is doubted. Okay, next paragraph. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Sigh means releasing a deep breath. Okay, sigh. Releasing a deep breath. Okay, I shall be telling this with a sigh. Sigh here means releasing a deep breath. Somewhere ages and ages hence. Hence here can be used as in the future. Okay, hence here is used in the future. Okay, somewhere ages and ages hence, he is saying that I shall be telling this with a sigh, with a deep relief. He will be telling this years and years after, in the future. Okay, two roads diverged in a wood. There were two roads, okay, in the forest, and they were diverged in two different directions, and I took the one less traveled by. Okay, he is saying I took the one which was less traveled. Again he is saying I took the one which is less traveled. In previous stanza he told that both the roads were very less traveled, or both were equally traveled. Okay, but before traveling, afterwards he came to know that this is both are equally traveled. But before traveling on this road, he thought that this was less traveled. So he took the one which is less traveled. Okay, so he is saying that with a deep relief, sometime in the future he will be saying that I took, there were two roads in the forest, they got separated to different directions, and I used the one which was less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. That means this way, or this road which he took, in his life that has made all the difference. That means that had changed his life. Okay, all the difference here, difference is a suspense here. Okay, we cannot say what kind of difference happened in his life. Okay, it may be good, bad, we don't know what kind of difference, but that has changed in his life. In what way it has changed, it is not given here, it is a suspense. But the road which he took, the other road which he took, has changed his life. Okay, till here I hope you all understood the poem. Okay, so once I'll read poem for you and you repeat after me. Okay. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood.
Two roads diverged in a yellow wood.
And sorry, I could not travel both.
And sorry, I could not travel both.
And be one traveler long I stood.
And be one traveler long I stood.
And looked down one as far as I could. To where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other just as fair. And having perhaps the better claim.
Because it was grassy and wanted wear.
Though as for that the passing there. Had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay. In leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept first for another day. At knowing how way leads on to way. I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I. I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. Okay, children, you understood this poem? Can you tell me what message poet wants to give through this poem?
Like the ice cream, I think we are afraid of making choices and taking risks.
Yes.
If we know about something, we want to go for that only.
Yes.
So I think the poet wants to tell us that we should try something new.
Yes, yes. We should try something new. In this poem, poet took the risk. Okay, he went on the road which is less traveled. He did not go to the road which was more traveled or commonly traveled by the people. Actually, we always want to go in a crowd. Okay, we always go for the easiest way, or we see where many people are going, we will go on that way only. But here poet took risk. And one more message he is trying to give in this poem, that the choices which you make in your life. Okay, message of the poem I'll write here. Okay, the choices that we take in our life. Okay, the choices that we make in our life decides our future, right? Okay, for what we will be known for. Okay, right? What message poet wants to give? The choices that which we make in our life. Okay, the choices that we make in our life decides our future. okay, and because of that future we'll be known for, we'll be identified with whatever we are doing in our future, okay. So before taking choices we should think over it, okay, we should think deeply what we are going to do and then we should take the choice. Or it is not like that anything you will select and anyone, because once you take some decision in your life you can't come back and go to the other decision. Yes, so before making any decisions or before making any choices we should think over it and then we should go to the right one which we feel, okay, exactly what we feel we are going to choose, that only, okay. I hope you all understood the poem. It was very nice poem, which and it gave a very good message also. Now we'll move towards the poetic devices of this poem. First we'll go to the rhyming scheme of this poem, okay. So see, can you tell me Rohini, what is the rhyming scheme of first stanza?
Wood rhymes with stood.
Wood rhymes with stood. So here for wood we are writing A, okay, A. Wood we will write A. Both
rhymes with growth.
Both rhymes with growth. So both here is not writing rhyming with wood. So we will write here B, okay. Stood again it's rhyming with wood. So again we will write here A. Code is also rhyming with wood and stood. So we will write here A, okay. And growth is rhyming with both. Okay, so we'll write here B. So what is the rhyming scheme of first stanza?
A
B A B. Okay, this is the rhyming scheme of first stanza. Now second, will you tell me?
Fair rhymes with where.
Yes, fair we'll write here A. Okay, claim. Claim is not rhyming with fair, so we'll write here B. Okay. Where is rhyming with fair, so again we'll write here A. There is also rhyming with fair and where, so we'll write here A. And same is rhyming with claim, so we'll write here B. So what is the rhyming scheme of second stanza?
A
B A B, okay, first and second both are same, okay. Now let's see third one, third stanza.
I think same it is, ma'am.
Same, na? Yes, very good. Lay is A, black. So we'll write there B. Again, day A, way A, back B. So same. Okay. And fourth stanza also it is same. So all four stanzas we are having same rhyming scheme, that is A B A B. Okay. Now we'll move towards the poetic devices of this poem. Can anybody tell me which poetic devices poet has used in this poem? Yes, Sandeep, you tell me.
I think it's metaphor, ma'am. It's a metaphorical poem.
Yes, metaphor. There are many poetic devices where metaphor is used.
Roads, they are showing our life.
Yes, very good, very good. Class for Sandeep. Okay, see, two roads here. Two roads are compared. Okay, metaphor means what? Comparison of two things without using like or as. So here two roads are compared. For making choice we are comparing, no, two roads. So here metaphor is used. Okay, metaphor is used. Again, what is used? What else is used? See, in the first line itself there is imagery also. Imagery is there. Yes, it is there. You can see imagery is there. Yellow wood. When we are talking about yellow, what you can visualize? Autumn season. Yes, you can visualize autumn season. Yellow wood means it's autumn season. Okay. So, what is imagery? Imagery means creating visualization. Okay, creating visualization. So here, imagery is also used. Okay. What else is used again? In the first stanza itself, you can see. See here, and is used. Okay, so when we are using same words continuously at the beginning of the lines, same words when we are using, that time we are saying that anaphora poetic device is used. Okay, so we are using here anaphora. Okay. because and is used in all three lines at the beginning. Okay, and you can see here also both stood and could. There is no punctuation mark. So which poetic device is used here? Here enjambment is used. Okay, when two or more lines continue without any punctuation marks, then we are saying that enjambment poetic device is used. Okay, enjambment poetic device is used. Next, what else is used in second stanza? Can you tell me? Wanted, where is there? Okay, I'll say you. Wanted, where is there? What is it? Which poetic device is used there? Near wanted, where?
Alliteration.
No. Right, it's personification. Because see, wanted where? We are talking about road. Road is not a living thing. Can road have wants? No. When we are using human attributes to non-living objects, that time we are using personification. Okay. So here, personification is used.
Ma'am, can I ask one question?
Yes, sir. Yes.
On one place, there can be two figures of speech can be there.
One place? Yeah. Yes.
Wanted where can be.
Wanted when can be alliteration also. Correct. I was going to that point only.
Yes.
You told. Okay. But I asked you. Okay. It was right. Alliteration. See. Wanted where. What is alliteration? Can you say me the definition of alliteration?
When
consonant sounds are repeated in the same line, that time we say as alliteration poetic device is used. So here wanted where is used. So where sound is repeated here. And one more, see in this second fourth line also you can see though, as for that, the passing there, which sound is repeated here? The sound is repeated. It is also consonant sound. So in this stanza alliteration is also used. Okay. Alliteration is also used. Okay. Again, anything else is left? Can you tell me? Repetition is also there
ages
in this poem.
Ages.
Yes, very good. Ages and ages. Words are repeated. And line is also repeated. You can see. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Two roads diverged in a wood. Yeah, okay. So lines are also repeated. So repetition is also used. So there are so many poetic devices in this poem. Why we are using poetic devices in the poem?
To make it beautiful.
Yes, to make the poem more beautiful, more effective, we are using poetic devices. Okay, so always Robert Frost is using many poetic devices. He is writing very simply, that means in very simple words, but with giving, it is giving you more meaning. So I hope you all understood this poem, children.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so thank you for today. We'll go meet in the next period.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.